Hey, good morning, everybody. How y'all doing? It's your boy, Rob Thomas Jr. from the Real New Behind New. Oh, yeah, today is December 22nd, 2018. And in this video, I just want to briefly touch on a couple of things that I think is very important for the people to know. First and foremost, I applaud Donald Trump for ending that illegal war in Syria. Because first of all, y'all, we had no business in Syria. We're basically over there trying to take them people's oil for the oil companies. One of the promises that Trump made when he was running to his voter base was that he was going to end the illegal war. Now again, first of all, we should have never been over there. We was over there for 7 years actually helping ISIS. We wasn't fighting ISIS. If you really go back, because I've been talking about this illegal war for 7 years, and if you go back and look at it, we were never trying to fight ISIS. It was the Russians, the Iranians, and the Syrians, and even the Turkish were fighting ISIS. The United States basically was supplying them. Now we got to ask the question, what's really up with that that whole situation? Hey, if he's bringing them home for good, that's cool. But most likely, they're going somewhere in Africa, because there's a dozen wars right now that we're fighting illegally in Africa. And they probably trying to get ready to just move the resources around. And Trump is playing the game, bringing them home for a little bit, then going to send them right back over there to another illegal foreign war. So pay attention to that. I think Tricky Trump is trying something. He's basically seducing the people. This is just my opinion, but based upon all the facts and past history, they need these wars because they need to continue to extract resources from other countries. Now, second thing I want to talk about real quick and real briefly is this thing with Israel. Did you know that 26 states right now have it where state employees have to sign a loyalty oath to Israel, saying that you promise, in order to get this job, you promise that you will not ever boycott Israel or any of their products. And now keep in mind, I'm not talking about the average person in Israel. I'm talking about the Israeli government, which is one of the most evil governments on the planet right now. They're an apartheid state. But you have to be aware of the control that they have over your government here in the United States. Whereas back in when they had the hurricane last year, or was it earlier this year in Houston? I think it was last year. Either way, the hurricane in Houston. Did you know, in order for any of those contractors trying to help rebuild Houston to get a job, they had to sign a loyalty oath saying that they pledge and promise never to boycott Israel? Guess what? I mean, you have the right to boycott anything in America, any other country's products, but for some reason, these American politicians, who are nothing more than whores and puppets for Israel, are telling you that if you say anything or you refuse to buy any Israeli products, that you can be held accountable. You have even got some people right now in legislation, trying to pass legislation, making it a crime to even speak against Israel. Why are we so embedded into Israel? Because they know too many secrets about what our government is doing. And plus, Israel has lobbyists like AIPAC and others who give tens of millions and millions upon hundreds of millions of dollars to these politicians, and they want that money train to keep going. So those two things, I just want to put them on your mind. And if you find, doing your research, you find anything different, just leave a comment in the comment section. But again, Tricky Trump, I think, is playing a game. And in Israel, we need to stand up as a people and start asking questions. Why are our politicians so indebted and so deep in the pockets of Israeli lobbyists and the Israeli government that they are willing to punish you for standing up for your rights? Because the Israelis right now are doing some of the most horrible things to the Palestinians, illegal things. Plus, they're an apartheid state. So why are we even doing business with them? Hey, this your boy, Rob Thomas Jr. Share this video. Subscribe to The Real New Behind New. To y'all hear my voice on another video, y'all be blessed.